In Baghdad today, the influential Iraqi information minister flatly denied a report that Iraq plans a new peace offer sometime after the 15th of January. Saddam Hussein said again, no retreat. In Baghdad, ABC's Gary Shepard.
In a defiant speech to delegates attending an international Islamic conference here today, Saddam Hussein accused the United States of trying to act like Rambo in the Middle East. The Iraqi president declared that Americans will be devoured by his forces, that he is not frightened by the more than 500,000 troops opposing him, and he is certain he will achieve victory against them. There was no mention of compromise, no hint he is willing to withdraw from Kuwait. If the Americans want this problem resolved, he said, they must put the Palestinian issue first. They were still shredding classified documents at the U.S. Embassy today as the ranking American diplomat and his skeleton staff made final preparations to fly out tomorrow on a special chartered jet. He appealed to all remaining Americans to leave with him. There are still an estimated 180 U.S. citizens in Iraq.
Given the warlike tone of Saddam Hussein's speech, the U.N. Secretary General's mission will not be an easy one when he arrives here tomorrow in a last-ditch effort to avoid conflict. Gary Shepard, ABC News, Baghdad.
This morning, the Secretary General exchanged views with European ministers in Geneva on his way to Baghdad as he boarded a plane for the Middle East. Mr. Perez de Cuellar said his mission was the last chance for peace. Here's ABC's David Ensor.
Plein succès, bonne chance.
The European foreign ministers wish the Secretary General good luck, saying they will not make any other diplomatic moves until they hear back from him. Earlier, Perez de Cuellar told them he will offer Saddam Hussein a five-part package. If, by January 15th, Iraq shows convincing evidence that it has started rapid withdrawal of troops from all of Kuwait, the coalition against Iraq promises it will not attack. The coalition withdraws forces too. The UN supplies observers to monitor the withdrawals, and a long-term peacekeeping force, excluding American soldiers or others in the coalition. Finally, Perez de Cuellar will say once the Gulf crisis is over, he will immediately push for a Middle East conference to solve the Palestinian problem.
Saddam Hussein does not accept this package, that is, in fact, saying in other words that he only wants war. And in that case, war will be, I would say, 100% justified.
The hope is that concessions Iraq's foreign minister did not make to Secretary Baker, Saddam Hussein just might make to the UN's top diplomat.
Acceding to a request of the Secretary General is not buying to a threat or anything like that.
Perez de Cuellar says his mission will only succeed if there is goodwill in Baghdad. Translation, if Saddam Hussein is looking for a dignified way out, Perez de Cuellar will help him to find it. David Ensor, ABC News, Geneva.
The Bush administration is sending one of its top State Department officials to Israel tomorrow to talk about the Gulf. If there is a war, Israel might end up fighting Iraq. Sandwiched in the middle is Jordan, whose leader, King Hussein, told ABC's Ted Koppel today that both Israel and Iraq should stay clear of his country.
We are determined to prevent any violation of our airspace or our land by any side to this conflict.
There will be more of that interview between Ted and King Hussein later this evening on Nightline. In a moment, Congress getting close to declaring itself on policy in the Gulf. In other news, Soviet tanks and troops have been used in Lithuania. And our person of the week, volunteering for the job.